please note the clearly marked exits on either side of the stage and exit in an orderly fashion.
We highly encourage all of you to wear masks, or else don't talk to me about paid sick leave.
The shift will be 2 hours long with a 10-minute intermission.
During the shift, performers will move through the house, so please stay in your seats and keep your aisles clear.
Lastly, please refrain from using flash photography, as it will distract us from our productivity and put those magical devices on paper airplane mode, as they will interfere with the quality of our live stream. Thank you, and have a great show.
Once upon a time, in a land far, far away, there lived these magical creatures called paper planes. Because they were made of paper, they were kind and gentle. Whenever the people in this ancient land wanted to go somewhere, they'd simply hop on a paper plane, and it'd take them wherever they wanted to go. When they grew tired of that new place, they'd hop on another one, and it'd take them right back home. The people loved the planes, and the planes loved them. Until one day.
Excuse me, you're reading that silly little book again?
Could you stop being self-critical for 1 minute?
No, it's my job.
You could just quit your job.
So could you.
That's ridiculous.
But you hate it with a fiery passion.
But those are the rules around here. I have to do it.
Doesn't working in the orchard till the day you die seem a little dull to you?
Well, it's my life.
Make something new. Make something of your own. You have so much enterprise, Mira. Everyone's always telling you that.
I don't even know how to use my enterprise.
Just learn.
Who's gonna teach me? You?
Yeah, you teach yourself these sorts of things. Look, I made that book there, didn't I?
That was just some silly little side project. I can't do more than that.
You can. I can help you.
How? How are you gonna do that? You're nothing. You're just my reflection.
Every day when I wake up, I wonder what I have to offer. Every day is just the same. One, two, and then another. I'm dissatisfied, I'm bored of the same old mirror, mirror. Scared of what some change could do. Who is that person in the mirror? Nervous and afraid to shout. You hide too much beneath your shell.
Mirror, mirror. Idea, and I'm not plotting. Soon, both sides of the orchard will be able to see what a beautiful world I can create.
Mira, we're gonna be late. I swear, if you don't come out of that door in 10 seconds, I'll leave you to face the wrath of Husk alone. 10, 9, it's a very good one.
Sorry, I'm here.
What took you so long?
Let's just say identity crisis.
Sounds rough. Come on, I told Zephyr we'd walk her to work since it's her first day.
Oh, shoot, it was her birthday yesterday, wasn't it?
And what about it?
Forgot to celebrate?
No one celebrates their 21st birthday.
Well, why can't we be the ones to start then?
Because it's basically a death sentence? Where do you get all those strange ideas from, anyway?
The strange ideas? Well, in my backyard. Quick, be quiet, she's coming. Let's pretend we're talking about something else.
Why?
So can be surprised.
Why?
Because surprises are fun.
But birthday parties are.
Hi, Tom. Hi, Mira. Sorry to keep you waiting.
Oh, that's okay. We were just talking about our favorite birds. I like birds that sing.
And I like the blue-eyed ground dove. Come on, we're gonna be late.
Oh no, I'm so sorry, Tom.
Don't worry, he's being dramatic.
Phew.
I'm not dramatic.
Oh, you're the least dramatic person I know. I'm just happy they put me in the lime orchard too. I would hate to never see you two again. What should I do with this anyway? They told me if I eat it, I can grow big and strong.
Never eat the limes.
What? Why?
Come on, buddy. There are a lot of things you don't know. Let's walk in. Or lemon, then for the rest of your life, every day you shall be cultivating your designated fruit tree. If that sounds crazy, I know we wanted to leave a long, long time ago. Now since you've come of age here in the kingdom, there are rules to be followed, and management will force you now to live them. You have to work until you die and never and the most wicked of all, you must use knife and fork to eat your given fruit every day that you work.
Well, at least lunch is free.
There's no such thing as a free lunch. I've heard the limes taste like curdled milk, and the rinds are made of leather with oils that'll burn away your eyes. And worst of all, once you've eaten one, you're stuck in the orchards forever. If that sounds crazy, we know we wanted to leave
a long, long time ago.
Does your brother know you feel this way?
Let's not talk about that.
Good morning, stewards. It's a beautiful day for beautiful work. Remember, the state of the orchard is emblematic of our accomplishments, not only as their caretakers, but also as people. Thus, it is imperative that they flourish under our care. That means no wandering aimlessly, no daydreaming, and no wasting enterprise. Here are your tasks for today. Mira, water sectors 1, 3, and 5. Tom, Zephyr, sector 6 is absolutely overrun with weeds. Deal with that. Hubert, Henley, pruning is sorely needed. Henley, help Hubert carry the shears. Please make sure that pruning is properly attained.
This is us.
Why do you never stop talking when I ignore you?
Well, I was just thinking that maybe instead of using all our enterprise at work today, we could save some for ourselves.
How many times must I tell you, girl, you think
think, but you don't know. Keep those silly thoughts out your head. They're a waste of enterprise.
Only is for the advancement of the kingdom.
Productivity is a one necessity. Low-bred dedication is our only currency in our society. And enterprise is only used to move ahead.
And if you don't make yourselves useful, then you're dead.
Good morning, Tom. Glad to see you made it into work on time.
I said I was just picking up a friend, Jeffrey, not skipping work.
Hey, Zephyr, right? Good to meet you. Glad to have you on board.
It's good to be you. I mean, it's see you nice here.
Oh, Mira, you're not supposed to be over here.
Come on, over there.
It's impossible that you don't know where you're supposed to be by this point.
Sorry, forgot.
Hey, you, I warned you about her, right? Ever since you were little and you used to come home from those playdates with your hands full of those silly paper airplanes. I mean, at least she doesn't waste her time on such worthless activities anymore.
We were four, Jeffrey.
I trust you're smart enough to not let her distract you from the great important job that you must do. Here in the orchard, we learn how to begin success, which brings us a lifelong happiness, saving the enterprise of the kingdom.
You're not, Mira. If you focused on your work, you'd be happy and successful.
Yes, Mrs. Yes.
That's the spirit.
Productivity is a one necessity. In a world of dedication, it's the only currency in our society. Enterprise is only used to move ahead.
And if you don't make yourselves useful, then you're dead.
Howdy there, Captain Tom. This is Ground Control speaking. Who taught you how to pilot this aircraft?
Mira, you're not supposed to have anything but uniforms past this point.
Guess whoever did an outright lousy job.
Husk is gonna take your head clean off with her giant pincers.
It appears you wildly misunderstood the directions here at Ground Control. You're supposed to be cruising at an altitude of 1,474 altitudes, and you're cruising at 4,701. I'm gonna need you to lower this aircraft in the direction of down.
Fine. Give me that. Ground Control, is it? I'm calling to let you know that it's actually Captain Mira here who's deliberately disobeying not only flight orders, but also the sacred pilot's oath. She's wrenched the controls away from me and she won't let go. And she keeps saying something about breaching the atmosphere.
I'll breach the starn atmosphere, so the last thing I do.
Oh no.
What if we actually did it though?
Breach the atmosphere?
No, I mean, what if we got paper planes and got out of here?
How?
With our Enterprise.
Mira, Enterprise can't do that. The planes leaving the orchard, Enterprise, those are all part of some stories we made up as kids.
Weren't you just telling Zephyr about how much this place sucked? And how much you wanted to leave?
Because she's Zephyr. You should know better.
When you turn 21 here in the orchard, you sign a form consenting to be tortured. Awake all the hopes and the dreams that we had. Now drop it, you'll thank me. Come on, don't be sad.
Watch.
stupid, stupid, stupid. Don't you dare nag me to go back to work.
I have to go because...
I know what you're gonna say. It's for your own good. Blah, blah, blah. But I've worked for that head of management, Silk, for long enough. For years, I have poured my heart into the upkeep of her stupid lemon trees, and what do I get in return?
I get what you're
her
saying.
Her still trying to shove lemons down my throat. No, I'm going to change this orchard. No more Silk, no more lemons, and no more distractions, Huntsman.
What did I do?
Ugh, you're talking!
Where did that petty little insect go? I'm asking you!
That way?
Maybe this way.
Honestly, I'm no match for a speedy Lexi Silk.
Okay, the next time you see her, make sure she won't disobey me again. Clear?
Mm-hmm. It was founded 2 seasons ago when she arrived. And a childlike wonder shone so bright. With a companion at first, she drove her off. Why do all children grow up so fast? She saw the world for the way that it was, not the way that I told her to. She wanted to change like a wildfire strikes, like the soil anew. But I said, these trees don't grow as swiftly as you might believe. New branches may burn, but high as they reach, they'll never bear new fruits. Don't believe when they say you're one of a kind. We all come from the same roots. But she plowed and sowed new seeds in the minds of old. I watched as they failed to grow. Hour by hour, by hour, by hour, slowly the fruits grew sour.
Bright, but here in the future nothing shines. I know what I have to do. Stop waiting for a man who's old and blind. Give me a chance. I can do anything, anything at all. I've had enough. I've tried to change what you see in the light. No one dared to care. Hour by hour, by hour, by hour, slowly the fruit grew sour. It's time to start my new plan. Time to take things into my own hands. Out with the old, in comes a new.
Mira!
What?
Look at this.
What is that?
Shh, don't let Mrs. Husk see it.
See what?
Nothing. Mira here has a severely infectious rash. You don't want to come near.
I don't recall it being your place to tell me what I can and cannot do. Give it to me. Where did you find this?
Over there. It fell off a tree as I was passing by and hit me in the head.
Which tree? Are you sure you didn't bump into it? Snap it off. Insult it?
I swear I didn't.
No, Tom couldn't have done this.
Don't you dare say it.
I wouldn't dare, Mrs. Husk.
Maybe it's a sign the orchard's dying.
Foolish child. What have I told you about speaking before you think?
Don't do it.
orchard has become unbalanced. Perhaps someone is stealing their own enterprise, daydreaming on the job. Of a life they aren't entitled to, and in so doing, stealing life from the orchard! Jeffrey!
Yes, Mrs. Husk.
This reeks of ambition. Dispose of it at once. Quickly, please. If other stewards get wind of this, they'll turn into a fear of swarms of fear and distrust. I trust you can remain discreet.
You can count on us, Mrs. Husk. I hope you and my brother can get to the bottom of this. If you need any help, please let us know.
Hopefully it's nothing. Mira?
Yes, my lips are sealed as the trunk of an oak tree.
Listen to me, girl. If you want to be the king's personal court jester, that sort of behavior is fine. But do you really want to be laughed at all day? The correct answer is no.
Yes, Mrs. Husk.
Good. Then keep your lips and mouth as shut mouth. Hurry along.
Oh, hey, I was looking for you two. Is everything all right with Husk?
Mrs. Husk.
Right, sorry, Mrs. Husk.
It's fine.
Yeah, everything is completely, totally, entirely fine.
What a normal thing to say.
Come on, let's just go home, please.
Roger that. You know, I always have wondered, who is Roger anyway? Well. Oh, hey, Mira, are you okay?
I don't know.
What if it is a sign?
The orchard's dying?
No. What if it's just a sign?
A sign
that something's gonna happen.
What do you mean? What do you think's gonna happen?
I don't know. That's the thing, though. You can't just sit around waiting for something to happen. You have to go and do it.
Do what?
Something. Things are already changing. The trees are turning to ash. It's a sign you should do something before it's too late. It's a sign you should talk to Sunshine.
What? Are you crazy? The fence is between the orchards for a reason.
A reason? Yeah, right. Keep telling yourself that.
It is, or else it wouldn't be there.
Trust me, it's a sign. You need to talk to her.
It's wrong.
Maybe everyone else is wrong. Have you ever thought about that?
You still don't get it. It's not supposed to be about what I think.
Fine. I'll do it.
How? How are you gonna do that? You're nothing. You're just my reflection.
You heard me. I'll do it. I'll show her what I'm all about. I told you, it's a sign. I'm coming out.
No.
Think about it, use your head. I'm the one who's got what it takes. Your normal self's just second rate. You'd make like 1,000 mistakes. You don't know how to talk to girls. You'd say the dullest things, no doubt. Just admit it, you're too scared. So I'm coming out.
Stop it, you're gonna ruin my life.
Good, you deserve it.
Thank you.
you're being awfully self-absorbed lately.
I just need to know that I'm the best, that I'm doing the right thing.
Well, the mirror only shows you the answers.
The answers, I believe, deep down are true. I know, that's why I keep asking it, who's the fairest?
I'm not sure I follow.
Don't you always want yourself to be the best person you know in a completely non-egotistical way?
No.
Suit yourself. I am making something new, Huntsman, and I have to be at my best doing it. Eventually, they'll all understand, including you.
I don't want to.
Someday, somewhere, something more will find you. Something in here will somehow set you free. One day your dream will become you, like it has with me. Then you'll understand how fierce the
be the time is right now. I've never seen something like this before.
That's because I made it. One day, a seed was planted in my mind, and I grew it from a thought to a tangible tree with my enterprise.
Impossible. You can't have made that.
The evidence is right in front of you. Go ahead. Try it.
You mean it can be eaten?
Yes. Try it. It's sweet.
It's doing little tingly things to my tongue.
It's as if I ate a good piece of journalism!
So you like it?
Like it? We love it.
This is the greatest thing that you've ever shown us. This is your magnum opus. People need to know Enterprise can do things like this.
What can we do to help?
Tell them to look for the sunfruit tree.
Tell them to look for the sunfruit tree. Tell them to look for the sunfruit tree. Tell who?
People like us who keep hoping for something better. They need to be shown they can make it themselves.
So you want us to spread the word?
No, I don't want you to just spread the word. I'll feed the tree. We're gonna start a movement, Finleys. We're gonna make this place unrecognizable.
Wonderful. Speaking of the sunfruit, do you happen to know where we could find more of it?
What are you doing so close to the fence?
Trying to do my job. Have you ever thought about that?
Oh, but the workday's over.
Husk gave me extra work.
Oh, and what would that be?
She told me to take a census. A fence census. A fences.
Okay, I highly doubt that, but also, when have you ever listened to Husk?
I do. Sometimes.
No, you don't.
Okay, fine. I'm going over to talk to a girl, but I'm only telling you because I value respect and honesty in a friendship, unlike someone who's constantly stalking me suspiciously.
Are you serious? What is going on with you?
You're not gonna tell Jeffrey, right?
Mira, you keep breaking the rules. I don't know what you want me to...
You're not gonna tell Jeffrey, right?
I'm gonna check on Zephyr.
Wait, Tom, wait.
Oops.
Once you show them both sides of you, they'll all turn their backs on you, and there's nothing at all you can do. You're touching the sky in your yellow sweater. You're touching the sky in your yellow sweater. Name? Oh, thank gosh, I thought I was gonna have to introduce myself.
I may have seen you a few times from across the fence.
You've been watching me? You're such a creep, Sunshine.
Oh, you're calling me a creep?
Yeah, I get to call you a creep because you've been watching me all season and haven't made a move.
Is this what you call making a move? Jumping over a fence just to insult me?
No, me making a move is telling you that I think we should be together because these orchards make up one ecosystem and the fence is just some arbitrary thing humans put in. Doesn't keep the trees apart. Why should it keep us?
That is the hottest thing I've ever heard anyone say.
It's crazy. You're like everything I imagined, and even better.
Really? Well, you're like someone took my dreams of you, made them real, and 1,000 times better.
1,000? How am I supposed to compete with that?
I don't know. What do people normally do in situations like these?
I don't know either, but do you want to spend the rest of our lives together?
Yes. No. No.
Run away with me. Leave these orchards behind.
Okay, you win, Mira. That's a lot to ask.
Sunshine! Where did you go?
Shoot, I have to go.
It's okay. Just think it over, Sunshine. The offer stands, and it's still standing.
How about now?
Still standing.
Sure, I'll think about it.
Time to go home!
I'm just so certain I'm gonna leave this place. I feel like I made up my mind ages ago. I want you to come with me.
Yeah, maybe one day, Mira. I like that very much.
It seems like you really have to go. You haven't eaten a lemon, have you?
No.
Okay, good. Because we in the lime orchard, we think that, you know, if you eat one,
you can never leave?
Yeah.
Sasha!
Okay, well, it really seems like you have to go.
Oh, wait. Don't go yet. How will I see you again?
I can be here tomorrow.
Where should we meet?
I was thinking here? Yeah, here.
Okay. Oh, wait. Don't go yet. Meet me at the sunfruit tree tomorrow.
What's a sunfruit tree?
Turn left on the greenhouse, walk straight until you come to a clearing. I'll explain everything tomorrow.
Okay.
Okay.
Bye.
When I'm with her, I see the sky.
Jeffrey, I have something to tell you.
What is it, bud? You know you can always talk to me, right? Oh, is it about your new friend, Zephyr? Right?
Zephyr? No. Should I be worried about her?
No, well, God, I don't know. It just, she doesn't seem to be picking up on things as fast as the others. You know, she constantly looks to you for guidance.
I haven't noticed. I'll admit I haven't been the most present lately.
Come on, what's the matter?
How do I become a part of management?
Well, hard work and an uncrushable spirit, Tom. You gotta make it known that you want it.
How do I do that?
Conversations like this for a starter?
Good. I love the orchard, and I want to be more dedicated to it.
Yeah, I'm glad you've come to that decision. Hey, you been eating your limes?
Yes, of course.
Okay, then you're gonna be fine. You'll be promoted in no time.
Really?
Yeah, I mean, hey, come here. Don't tell anybody this, but I've been talking to Husk, and I mean, you're the perfect candidate for management. Plus, hey, you're my brother. You'll be a shoo-in.
Wow, that was easy.
Sure is. Pretty soon, it'll be you and me, running about, running the place. We'll have the life we've always wanted. Doesn't that bring a smile to your face? Great big house, important job, the utmost respect of your peers. And eventually, two families, barbecues with our wives and our kids. We'll have a lime of a time out here in the trees. We'll own the whole darn place and bring dissenters to their knees. We'll have a lime of a time running the whole show. We'll make bank and hardly work once we make it to the top. Hello, it's a lime of a time, Tom, just you and I. Once your head's in the game, it's as easy as key lime pie. Come on, Tom. Have a lime of a time out here in the trees. You'll find once you get started, it's as easy as a 1, 2, 3.
This is it? The sunfruit tree?
Yeah, isn't it beautiful?
It's different than anything I've ever seen.
Yeah, we haven't seen anything like it until just a few nights ago. Here. Try.
Do you really want? She made it with her enterprise.
She made it with enterprise? Oh my gosh, I've been wanting to learn for so long.
I really don't think that's a good. Oh, okay.
Take a breath, picture what you want, set your head, make plants bloom, make rain fall, you
witch who lives deep where the shadows thin. She can grant your every wish, or she'll tear you from limb to limb.
Don't be afraid to gut her. The witch hears all of your anguish. The witch hears all of your cries. The witch is making a brand new world where the sun fruits always rise. Open your eyes. Find out the sun fruits rise.
Oh,
birthday party?
Maybe you shouldn't live in fear of Jeffrey all the time. Maybe your brother is an incompetent, egotistical maniac.
Mira!
Yeah, I've been waiting to say that one for a long time.
This is not about my brother, and you know it.
Yeah, it's about you being too afraid to accept change.
No, it's about you trying to destroy the orchard!
Oh yeah? How'd you come up with that conclusion in your flea-infested brain?
It's crazy how you're the only one who doesn't see it, right? Right, guys?
Just leave me out of it. It's all I'm saying.
I don't know what's going on!
You know, I sort of see what you're talking about.
Shut up, Zephyr.
Stop blaming Zephyr. You're the one who's in hot water right now. Not doing your work, stealing Enterprise away from the orchard for yourself.
It's my Enterprise, Tom. I'm not stealing it from anywhere. That's not how it works.
Oh, so now you're an expert on how it works, because you made a bunch of paper airplanes fly all over the place. Well, I have news for you. That's what paper airplanes are supposed to do. Fly!
Oh yeah, well then wouldn't it make sense that a bunch of paper airplanes are what's turning the trees to dust?
Oh
what?
My god.
You didn't hear that, Zephyr.
Mira, you useless piece of plywood!
You're the one who let it slip first. You accused me of destroying the orchard, remember?
What do you mean the trees are turning to dust? The trees are turning to dust!
Me too! But you don't get to wish that! This is your fault! Don't worry, Zephyr, it's fine. Everything is normal. This is totally fine. Nothing is dying. In fact, just forget about it. Forget about everything you saw just now.
Did you say the orchard is dying?
The orchard is fine. Mrs. Husk and Jeffrey have it under control.
Oh, yeah? How can you be so sure it's not management's fault that the orchard is?
The orchard isn't dying! Mira, what was that?
It worked. It came back.
Oh, what's on top of it?
It's like a plant.
Ow, what happened? Let me try. Ow! It has little fuzzies. I thought they would be soft.
Tom, touch it.
Why would I? Ow!
This came from outside the orchard. I asked my Enterprise to show me what somewhere outside the kingdom looked like, and it worked. This is real, okay? And it means so many things. Well, for one, we don't have to stay here wasting our Enterprise working for management anymore, right?
Mira, look, you can't believe everything you hear about this Enterprise thing. I mean, sure, maybe it can make some paper airplanes fly a little higher, but it can't take you out of the orchard. It can't sustain you.
Yeah? Well, then how do you explain this?
It caught on a burr and fell back down.
You just called this a burr? That'd be a pretty huge burr.
Well, there's a first time for everything.
Okay, fine. I'll just show you how much Enterprise can do. And trust me, it can do mind-blowing things. Meet me by the fence at midnight.
Why?
We're gonna find the witch. Sunshine told me she's the greatest Enterprise user in the whole orchard. She'll show you something you'll just have to believe.
Are you going to?
Are you not going?
Of course I'm not. She's got twigs for brains. I can't reason with her.
Well, what if I'm going too?
Suit yourself. I can't stop you.
You're not even gonna try?
What use would it be?
What if I wanted you to try?
Just go, Zephyr!
We'll have a lime of a time, Jeffrey, you and I. It turns out getting what I want isn't as easy as key lime pie. But I'll still have a lime of a time doing what is right. I'm trying to steer two ships, but now it's time to join one fight. I'll have a lime of a time finding who's responsible for turning what would be ours to dust and holding them accountable. It's not who I am, but it'll be beaten in my pride. It's who I'll become. By having a lime of a time. I'll have
on the wall, who's the fairest of them all? No, that can't be right. Do it again, mirror. Mirror, mirror on the wall, who's the fairest? It's not her, okay? It can't be Mira, so stop showing her. She is not better than me.
What's the problem?
Ugh, go away.
I'm worried about you.
Oh, you're worried? Fine, be worried about this. Your mirror's broken, Huntsman.
Would you look at that? First time is not your thing.
But it should be me.
Well, apparently that's not what you think because the mirror only shows you the things
I believe are true. I know, but I don't think Mira from the Lime Orchard is better than me. This mirror is broken.
It's not broken. Well, now it is.
What was that?
What?
Did you hear that? Someone's coming.
That's why I came to tell you that.
I could have sworn I was around here somewhere.
Just admit it, we're lost.
We are not lost. We just forgot which way was the right way.
Why is this one tree so special anyway?
Because, Zephyr, it's a sunfruit tree. And it's the only one of its kind.
Then why'd they only make one?
A very special person made it. They call her the witch. She made it to prove that we can carve our own paths that don't involve lemons or limes. At least that's what I think it means. That's another great thing about it too. You can decide for yourself what it means to you.
That's silly. Where would we be as a society without lemons and limes?
You're still new to all of this. You don't understand, but that's okay.
Hey, wait a second. Is that it?
No,
it can't be. I thought it would be bigger.
Where are the other trees?
They've been destroyed.
Looks like they've been cut down.
That's what I just said.
Just wait till you try Sanford, okay, Zephyr? I don't understand. I was just here yesterday and I tasted one and it was the best thing I've ever had. You have to believe me, Zephyr.
Well, this is a drag.
Shut up!
I'd leave if I were you.
Whoa!
Why are you screaming?
Honey, it's because you snuck up on them.
Oh, shoot, I did, didn't I?
Oh, but it's okay. You're fine, I'm fine, everyone's fine, I'm fine.
Okay, I'm so sorry. Yes, I'm sorry, we're closed. I'd leave if I were you.
Closed?
Yes, everybody came by yesterday and picked the sunfruit tree all clean, so yes, I'm sorry, we're closed. I'd go home if I were you.
What's gonna happen now if there's no sunfruit?
Well, I think the witch is thinking about expanding, hence the,
destruction!
Trimming.
Why are you not wearing management-issued orchard-identifying garments? Who are you?
Doesn't matter who we are. We're here to talk to the witch. Do you know where we can find her?
No. The witch doesn't speak to nobodies like you.
We're not nobodies. Tell her my name's Mira, and I'm Sunshine's friend. Do you guys know Sunshine? Anyways, I'm an enterprise user just like the witch, and I can help her bring beauty and meaning back into the orchard.
No. The witch is not gonna want to speak to you. Is she, honey?
No, honey, not at all.
Well, respectfully, I'm not gonna let her hench people tell me what I can or can't do. Get out of the way.
Watch where you go, there's muck ahead. Meddling will get you stuck unless you end up dead, which is probably what you'll be.
Letting you.
yourself, get out of line. Don't yourself become her kind.
Who?
Shoot, shoot, shoot! You shouldn't have let them go! You should have been there to stop them! What were you thinking, twit brain?
Tom? Is that you?
Jeffrey!
What are you doing by the fence?
I dropped something.
Was it your common sense?
I don't understand.
Tom, I've begun to find that you're not focused half of the time. Tom, I've begun to wonder where your head has gone to make such a blunder. I mean, thinking about crossing the fence, are you really that dense? Are you made of bricks? Now that's just sick. Now that's a sign that you, young man, are out of line.
I wasn't going to cross the fence.
Oh, yeah? Then what were you doing standing by it with your hands over your head?
I was praying.
You're lying, you're slipping, you're losing your focus. How are we to expect you to perform to management standards if you keep on doing silly things like this? I mean, do you even want to be a part of management?
Yes, I do.
Oh, yeah?
Jeffrey,
yeah?
Please,
sure.
Believe me, I
sure,
do.
Pal.
I want nothing more
sure.
In the world.
Yeah?
Then what were you doing standing by the fence?
Mrs. Husk.
Boys, I've been saying for a long, long time, boys will get out of line. Too much pressure and they'll crack. Give them a loose hand and they won't run back.
Tom's a good kid.
I don't doubt that. But even the good ones can go off track. Tom, you're acting out of line. You're not behaving by design. But you knew that already, right? We're gonna need some discipline. Maybe some light punishment. A whip and a crook at least to wrangle him back in line.
Plain and simple, I'm over it. This silly act has to stop now. You think it's funny, but it's inappropriate to break the rules inside her house. Oh, you've just been out of line, whether in rain or shine. Starting to wonder where I went wrong. It's a pity I trusted you for so long.
I didn't do anything wrong. I don't deserve the blame. I didn't do anything wrong. I don't deserve your shame.
If the line were a great brick wall, some people would pick bricks out. They pick and the bricks would fall till the wall came tumbling down.
Till the wall came tumbling down. Till the wall came tumbling down. Till the wall came tumbling down. Till the wall came tumbling down.
Who are you talking about?
Oh, come on! You haven't been able to pick it up from the context clues? The witch. That's who.
Honey! You do not want to meet her. You don't want to make the same mistake we did. Of trusting her.
And who else would be to blame for your own wretched behavior?
Mrs. Husk?
I asked Tom.
Mira? Mira went over to the lemon orchard just now. She says she's looking for a witch to help her with Enterprise, but I just know she's the one destroying the orchard.
That's a strong accusation. Are you sure?
She's the one out of line.
I don't know.
We haven't got too much time.
I am not leaving until you explain.
I know you might be resigned, but your life is on the line.
She's coming, get out of here!
Never let go of me. No, no!
Just listen to me.
Little Mira, are you sure? about? I thought you and Tom told me to forget all of that.
You can forget that. We told you to forget about it. The trees are dying, and I know what's causing it. It's the witch. She may not know it, but that doesn't make her innocent. She's using her enterprise to blow up all those trees. One of the first things I learned about enterprise is that you can never use it to destroy.
Why not?
I don't know. It wasn't really explained to me, but I know that it can lead to other bad things happening, like other trees dying.
Sounds bad. Why should I help you? You heard what that couple said. The witch would probably kill us.
I didn't say that.
Well, it was heavily implied.
All right, fine. If you're not going to do it for me, at least do it for Tom. He'll finally get the peace and quiet that he's been wanting.
Yeah. Yeah, that's good. Then maybe I could finally walk him home after work one day.
What?
And make him dinner? He's laughing over something stupid I said.
Zephyr, stop talking.
And then when we say goodnight, I'd rest my head against the door frame, and he keeps the screen door at bay, and we just can't tear our eyes off each other.
Please stop.
Eventually, I tell him, "See you tomorrow, partner," and he responds, after a fond pause, "Partner," and he watches me go.
Are you finished?
No.
Yes, you are. I don't care to hear about how you have the hots for Tom. Are you ready?
Ready as I'll ever be.
Let's go.
Let's go catch a wit! Oh, did I say witch? I meant to say something else, like wizard.
Mira, stop right there.
What's going on?
Your gig's up. I told them everything. I'm very sorry, I had to. You understand.
Mira, I must say I'm disappointed in you, dear girl. I don't really know what I expected, but certainly better than collaborating with an evil villainess who is hellbent on destroying the orchard. I mean, do you really hate this place that much?
I wasn't collaborating. I was trying to help you.
Typical girl, always lying when she gets caught.
Jeffrey, let's handle this civilly. Zephyr, is disobedience spreading like the plague? Word is you also crossed the line to catch the witch, which, might I remind you, is strictly forbidden by regiment standards.
Did Tom tell you that?
I know you only joined our workplace culture a short while ago, so you may not understand the full extent of our rules. Is that correct?
Yes. I didn't know where she was taking me. I was innocent and eager to please, and she preyed on that. She led me out of the orchard, and I didn't know it wasn't okay.
So you're saying that Mira took you across the line against your will?
Yes.
Mira, that won't help!
Mira, come back here.
I didn't want to lose you too.
Me neither.
Sunshine, please, where are you? I know that you're probably avoiding me, but I really need you right now. Sunshine!
I need you too. I need you now more than you'll ever know is true. I want you by my side forever, so
for you on every star.
Are these all sunflower trees?
Yes. Isn't it amazing? Now everyone can have as much as they want. Maybe pretty soon the whole orchard will be covered.
Did the witch do this?
Yeah. Who else could have done it?
Sunshine, listen, you have to stay away from the witch. She's dangerous.
Why would you say that? She's just trying to spread a message.
And what message is that exactly?
That things can be brighter, more beautiful, sweeter. That you can take fate into your own hands and create anything you've ever wanted.
But that's not what's shown here, is it? These are all sunfruit trees.
So it's better than lemons.
That may be so, but what are people gonna think when they see this? They're just gonna take and take and take. They're not inspired by this because they know the second they pick it all clean, the witch is just gonna make more. And I'm sorry, but the witch has sold herself out to the ease and convenience of making the same thing over and over again and calling it beautiful. The sunfruit tree was beautiful because it was the only unique thing in this orchard. But now, I don't know what it stands for anymore, and I don't know what she stands for anymore, but I know that this isn't real enterprise. Not the stuff that you're talking about.
How are you to judge whether enterprise is real or not? You barely know! You know nothing! Just let it go, Miro.
No, I know that if the witch continues doing this, just making sunfruit trees, she's just gonna create another orchard no better than the lemon orchard we have now. And she'll be in complete control, and I'm not sure if that's what she wants, but that makes her dangerous to me. No better than the management that we have now.
She is not like management at all.
Sunshine, management is coming after me, and they're coming after the witch too. So if you want to leave this orchard, now would be the perfect time to...
I'm not going to leave with you.
Sunshine, open your eyes.
No, I don't want to leave. And I made that clear from the very beginning. It's your own fault if you willfully thought that I changed my mind.
Sunshine, please.
No, you leave then. Run away. If you always wanted to do so badly, then why don't you?
Oh, right. It's because you never had the guts, and you never will. Sunshine.
No, stop it. Just stop. I told you to let it go. You don't know when to stop, do you? I'm done talking about this.
Who's the fairest?
Let it go. It's not good to obsess over things like this.
No, but I have to know. Why? Why do I still see her?
Please, let me take you back.
No, get your hands off me.
Let me do something for you. Anything.
Have to go.
What are you talking about?
That they're not right. As much as I hate to admit, Mira is correct. If I create an orchard full of sunfruits, then I am no better than soap with her orchard full of lemons. We have to do some more landscaping once again. God!
Sunshine, are you okay?
Mira, I must say I'm disappointed to find you here.
And where else would I be exactly?
Why, the orchard, of course. If you were a good, rule-abiding girl, you would have run straight back to the orchard and turned yourself in.
I can't believe you.
Neither can I.
I was trying to help you. I was trying to figure out who's responsible for the orchard dying.
And I told you not to get involved.
The state of the orchard is very precarious, my girl. You jumping back and forth across the fence like that? How do you know it wasn't you killing those trees?
Because that's ridiculous. Do you hear yourself? I can lead you to the witch. She's the one that's been turning all the trees into ash, which is what I was trying to tell you before, but you wouldn't listen to me.
The witch? We already got her.
What?
Yeah, the witch. We already found her. It looks like we found her accomplice, too.
Is that really necessary?
Better safe than sorry.
I guess you're right. Jeffrey? Tom?
Sunshine?
I should have known. All along I should have guessed that it was you. All this time left me in the dark, not knowing what to do. When all this time there you were, behind every thought and every turn. How did I get as lucky as I did meeting you?
Jeffrey, detain her.
You have no idea how long I've wanted to do this.
Probably not the best choice of words right now, Jeffrey.
Sasha! Please, let her go. She didn't know what she was doing. Great dark evil power has overtaken her, please.
I have made it very clear that you have to be make sure that she won't disobey me ever again.
I feel like that. Just release her to me, okay? She's a good home walking girl. I'll make sure she will never have to be again.
Stand back.
Please.
Stand back.
Please!
We're sorry, the baby, you understand.
All right, stop gawking or else you will end up the same like them.
If you take a look at the orchard, you'll see that all the trees are dying. And the second we start to believe this beautiful, magical thing that sustains us isn't alive, we aren't either. The things we love, they die too. So now you know who's at fault.
Enough of it! I'm done with this. The punishment will start tomorrow. And for me, I will start saying goodbye to my favorite limbs if I have to.
Get a good night's rest, girls.
I think that if you were to only ask, I'd give you every treasure that
I'm a brave person?
Yes. I'm sorry for what I said earlier. If there's anyone brave enough to leave this all behind, it's you, Mira. You can do anything.
Sunshine, I
We thought maybe we could...
We're sorry, Mira. We're so sorry. We didn't know.
I didn't know it would come to this.
You should get out of here, both of you.
What are you talking about?
We thought maybe we could help you escape.
We brought paper.
We thought maybe you could make it into a paper plane and we could help you make it fly or whatever.
Teach us how to use our enterprise and we could help you. With all of us working together, we could fly you out of here.
That's
wonderful. Go. You've always wanted to get out of here. This is your chance.
What about you?
I think I need to stay. To fix all the damage I've done tonight. And this time, I'll do it the right way.
Then I'll stay with you.
If you don't go now, you might never have another chance.
Sometimes it's better to stay and fix things the right way.
Mira, no. You should leave before Silk decides which of your fingers and toes she'll cut off.
Hint, I think it's gonna be all of them.
I don't care. Who cares about what's out there? What if it's just another orchard? At least here, I'll be with you. I've lived my whole life in the orchard, and I've never been very good to it. I'll help you restore it.
Mira, don't be stupid.
I think you should go. Zephyr, you too. Sorry things didn't work out the way you wanted.
Well, what do you want to do now? You have plenty of time.
Have you heard the story about the paper plane?
Yes. Who hasn't?
Well, I kind of made this illustrated version of it a while back. It's nothing, but it's something I'm really proud of. Do you mind if we read it one last time?
I'd want nothing more in the whole wide world.
Once upon a time, in a land far, far away, they lived magical creatures called paper planes. Because they were made of paper, they were kind and gentle. And whenever the people in this ancient land wanted to go somewhere new, they'd simply hop on a paper plane's back and it'd take them wherever they wanted to go. When the people grew tired of that new place, they'd simply hop on another plane and it'd take them right back home. The people loved the planes and the planes loved them until one day a new king took the throne. Now the king grew frightened that the people would find a new place and leave his kingdom for good. So his first ruling was to order the sun to shine 12 times as bright the next day. When the paper planes took off, they caught a flame and burned away. The people, shocked and frightened by what the king did, decided to leave the kingdom for good, one by one, family by family, until they reached a lush meadow. But there was one problem. They had no food, no belongings, there were no trees. Everything they had was used or stolen. Until one of the people discovered two seeds in their pocket and planted them in the ground. These trees bear fruit, two different kinds, limes and lemons.
You rot to fruit in my orchard, and I'm not gonna stand for that!
I think of what I could become. I think of what I could become. I think of what. there's smoke.